Hi, in this lecture, we are going to cover simple interest. We have a lot of topics like simple interest, compound interest, and there is a lot of theory that goes on in this. But before we get on to the whole details, I think we should know what is interest. Interest is a kind of a premium that is earned when you loan some money out. For example, if you give someone, let's say, 100 rupees, okay, then you're probably expecting that guy to pay you back the 100 rupees at a certain period of time, after a certain period of time. And also, since you've done him a favor of giving him money at a, you know, when he needed it, I think he should pay you something other than the 100. That extra becomes your interest. Normally, in all the business transactions, the interest rate is predefined or negotiated upon. So what happens is when you go to a bank and you want to take a loan, the loan will come with a certain rate of interest. That is the interest that we are talking about when we talk about simple interest or compound interest. The premium earned on loan given out or money given out. Now, simple interest, how does it really work? In a lot of questions, what we will see is that the question maker would ask you, suppose if 100 rupees are loaned out at an interest rate of 10% for 1 year, then how much would be the interest after 2 years? Okay? After a certain period of time, or when something like this is not given to you, someone might just ask you that, hey, I have just earned a simple interest of, let's say, 200 rupees after 2 years when I had loaned the money out at 10% compounded annually. I'll tell you what is compounded or something. So, you know, what would be my principal? Okay, this quantity, these things will be asked for, you know, asked in the questions. So how do we calculate simple interest or the principal or the rate or the time or something like that? The basic formula is SI is equal to PRT upon 100. Now in this formula, what is P, what is R, what is T? We know SI stands for simple interest. Now if I say P is the principal, now what does that really mean? Principal is the base amount. It is the base amount. Like if I have said I have loaned out 100 rupees, if I have loaned out 1 lakh rupees, if I have loaned out 10,000 rupees, if I have loaned out 682 rupees, these amounts are the principal amounts that have been loaned out. This is called the principal. Okay, that's your P. Now R is the rate of interest. This is this. So, rate of interest, as I've already told you, is a quantity that is predefined or negotiated upon. And this quantity is calculated in percentages. Okay? So, you have 10%, 12%, 6%, 6% on savings account and so on. So, that is your rate. Now, the T here stands for time. Okay? The time period, the duration. On which, okay, this is not the time period after which the whole transaction gets completed. It does not mean that, you know, 5 years, after 5 years, you pay me the whole thing. Okay. And that becomes my complete transaction period. It is not like that. The T here stands for the time after which I will calculate the interest. Okay. It means the interest calculation, at what frequency is it done? Okay, probably someone has loaned you some amount and he wants, like, pay me back after every month. You know, pay me an interest after every month or after every day. Someone is really bad, he's going to ask you interest after every day. Normally you have quarterly, you know, calculation of interest. Normally you have yearly calculation of interest, tri-monthly or so on, you know. So this is the time after which the calculation of interest is done. So now we know P into R into T upon 100 gives me the simple interest. Now, let's take an example question here. If I have to make, let's say, 200 rupees every year. Okay, I have to make 200 rupees just by giving money out. Okay, what is the principal that I should loan out so that I make 200 rupees annually at an interest of 10%, which is charged again annually? Right? In this case, we know that the time period to be calculated here is a year, because the person wants to make 200 rupees every year. The simple interest becomes 200. The rate becomes 10%. We want to find out the principal. Our formula says SI is equal to P into R into T upon 100, which implies 200 is equal to, P is unknown, so we'll just keep P as P. R, the rate of interest is 10%, so keep it at 10, into time period is T, 1 year, so that becomes your formula. Now P, just by transposing everything over here, becomes 200 into 100 upon 10. So, loan out 2000 rupees. Now, to earn a simple interest of 200 rupees at the end of the year. So that's basically the whole story about simple interest. I'll tell you something about one thing that we want to know. You know, one thing that we missed out here is the whole calculation when the time period is different. You know, if the time period is not a year, how would you calculate it? So if I say the T is, let's say the person is calculating every month the interest, so it becomes 1 by 12 of a year. Okay, in the previous example we had 1 year, so we used 1 year. Now if the person says do it monthly, you know, the calculation of interest, do it monthly, then it becomes 1 by 12 of an year. Right? So my formula becomes SI is equal to P into R into T. Now the T here is, suppose, you know, they say you have to calculate for a month, so it becomes T by 12, which is 1 by 12 of the formula. Fine? So this is how you calculate it for time periods which are not of the multiple of an year. So that's the whole thing about simple interest. Go on to the practice questions. Really, really go through them, and let's see you in the next lecture. Thank you.